This is GBC Web TV, on the internet at gbcweb.tv. Welcome to Greenford Baptist Church in West London. Here you can watch inspiring biblical teaching and other excellent Christian videos. You can order the teaching video DVDs, listen to and study the audio versions of these, or download them as audio podcasts to your computer or MP3 player.
Kim is the minister at Greenford Methodist Church. As Tony supports, it's not that Lee has sloped off this morning surreptitiously to come here and be baptised. Kip and I have talked about this, and Kip supports Lee's decision to be baptised here today 100% totally. So that's why we're doing this for him.
Well, I've lived quite an enjoyable life, so I thought. I've been involved in a lot of things that are not very nice. I've done a lot of not very nice things to a lot of people. What I've learned is you can't make life on your own. You need friends, you need family, you need support. Also, you need God on your side. To quote a phrase, I was a soul that was lost, now I am found.
Amen.
I've lived in a world where I've been violent. There's times in my life when it was very dark. It was the spark, the light at the end of my tunnel to get me through. Sometimes, I didn't live as he wanted, but I was mindful of what he told me. And this has always led me back. Even though I've turned away and gone and done what I wanted to do again, I've still been brought back. He hasn't never given up on me. Even when my life has been in danger, he's saved me from my enemies. I've had an experience where I should have lost my life, but I didn't. People coming to save me who shouldn't have been there, and then discounting that and just going back to the way I was. And then years later, on an Alpha course, God spoke to me through the Psalms and explained that it wasn't just luck or fate. It was pre-planned that he was there, he saved me. He stretched forth his right hand. What I'd like to say really is just to strengthen people that, he never gives up on you as much as you disappoint. And all the things that you do, you think, I'm further and further away from God. Not so. I've lived and learned and I've made a lot of mistakes, but I'm proof that God doesn't give up on anyone. He loves us all.
Amen. Yeah. Romans chapter 6 says this. Don't you know that all of us who are baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were therefore buried with him through baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. If we have been united with him like this in his death, we will certainly also be united with him in his resurrection. For we know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body of sin might be done away with. Now, if we died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. Amen. This here symbolizes, it's more than symbolizes, but symbolizes our union with Christ. As we go down into the water, is about the fact that we are leaving a particular way of life. As we go underneath the water, it is about our union with Jesus. We are sharing in his death. And we see, when somebody dies, all the claims that people have had on them in their life cease to be. And in this union with Christ, in his death, all the stuff that Satan would hold against us, all the powers and forces that will cling on to us are broken off as we die with Jesus. There is terrific liberation, a setting free, amen?
Amen.
But we don't leave them underneath the water. Lee said to me beforehand that some people here might be disappointed that we don't leave him underneath the water. But we're even going to bring Lee up out of the water. And as they come out of the water, it is about a union with Christ. It's a sharing of resurrection life. We don't believe in, are you ready, church? High in the sky when you die, it is eternal life isn't something that begins for us in the bright room of yonder. Eternal life is something that begins for us now. And as we come out of that water, we share Christ's new life and we go on to live life with him. And whilst this is symbolic, it isn't just symbolic. In Romans chapter 6, it is clear that what takes place here is a spiritual event. What we see take place is a physical event. But the deeper and the more real and the more significant thing that's going on actually is a spiritual event that this signifies and symbolizes. It's very clear in the Bible that baptism, I was talking to somebody this week who's actually being baptized in a few weeks' time, and they were saying to me, you know, I've been putting this off and putting this off and putting this off, and I finally come to realize that baptism is not optional. Baptism is not optional. Whenever you see in the New Testament people becoming Christians, they're baptized straight away, usually the same day. This is not an optional extra.
Confess Jesus Christ as your Saviour and Lord.
Yes.
And do you turn from sin, renounce evil, and intend to follow Christ?
I do.
And would you seek to live within the fellowship of his church and to serve him in the world?
I will.
Let's pray for Lee, shall we?
Lee, what a momentous day. The Lord has truly been waiting for you. I just wanted to share a word of scripture with you. Ye are the light of the world, a city that is set on a hill that cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light shine, Lee, before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Heavenly Father, this is an awesome, absolutely awesome time. Lord, it's been a long time in coming. But you know what? Everything in your time. Lord, you know, I believe that the devil is going to be upset today. I think he's going to be mightily upset today. Because he thought that he had you, but you've proven him wrong. Lee, today you're making a public declaration of your love for the Lord. And you know what, Lee? You know what's really awesome about today? That we have another man in the army to fight the battle. There's not enough men out there fighting the battle. But Lee, you decided to put on the armour of God and to fight the battle. It's indeed a blessed day. And Lee, you know, I pray that the Lord will continue to increase his territory through you whilst you work for the youth. And I pray that the Lord will strengthen you in the trials that are ahead. Because then you know what? The water's good. And can you hold it down a little bit longer? The water's good. God is good.
All the time.
God is good.
Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. Our gracious Father, we just want to commit your soul into your hand. We thank you because yes, indeed, you have been the one for times before, oh God, that knew that this day is going to come. And Lord, you have made it possible. Lord, we are saying thank you. Lord, we plead for his life, that you will take hold of him and make an example of him, God, to the nations, Lord, in the name of Jesus. People will see what you can do with a man, oh Lord. People will see his life change and be surprised and say, you mean God can do this? Lord, this is what you are going to do in his life, Lord. And many others will come to know you through this life, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We know as you took Apostle Paul, he was a persecutor of the church, but Lord, at the end he became one of God who suffered greatly in your name. So, Lord, you shall do in the life of him, Lord, even much more in Jesus' name.
Barbara, thank you, Philly. Thank you that I've had the privilege and the pleasure of seeing the work we've done with people, Father, in the past, and I thank you for that. I thank you that God has been using you, Father. But Lee, to you, it's sort of like a TV analogy. You've seen God at work in you and through you. You've seen God at work in young people. But what you've seen so far, it's not watching a film at home on a 20-inch telly. You've seen God at work. You're going to see God at work, and your relationship with God is going to be like going to the cinema, widescreen, surround sound, the lot. That's going to be the difference. You ain't seen nothing yet, boy. You haven't seen anything yet. Yes, you've seen God at work. Yes, you've seen Him working in you and through you. But now, as you give yourself fully to what God wants to do in and through you, it's going to be such a difference, and you're going to see what God can really do through you. Once you let Him take over, and when you let Him do what He wants to do in you and through you, I thank you for that, Lord. I thank you that He's taking this step of faith, this step of encouragement for others as well, Father God. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Lee, I've never met you before today, but I can feel that the party that's going on in heaven, I can hear it already. But what I also felt as you spoke to us was like one of the previous prayers said, Satan's not going to be happy about this. And this is going to be a momentous, wonderful day, but you need to hold on to it, and you need to hold on to God fast, because He's going to keep digging away at you to say, come on, you've made the wrong decision, haven't you? You really don't want to be doing that. Don't let Him dig at you. Put on the armour of God, surround yourself with godly people, and don't let Him get to you. Amen.
Yeah, I've never met you, but just listening to you. The Lord says that you were strong and bold in all the things that you have done in your past. The same boldness, the same braveness, and the fearless man in the danger that you had done. God says He's going to use that around for the same boldness and fearless spirit that you had for His glory. You are going to be His soldier with that steel of the nerve for Him. You are going to serve Him, and He's going to stand by you and walk with you. So trust in the Lord, and God is with you.
Just turn around and look at me for a moment. Lee, when you were just walking up here, I just felt God show me something in you. I don't know you well. I mean, I met you for the first time to sit and talk just a couple of weeks ago. But you're a guy who, before you became a Christian, was frightened of nothing. Okay, you were fearless. You had weapons in your hand. You knew how to use them. If someone needed sorting, you sorted. So if someone needed standing up to, you stand up to them. If someone needed putting down, you'd put them down. You'd sort them out. That was the sort of life that you led. And that's the sort of life you're going to lead now, but in a different way. Because you see, you look around, don't turn around, but if you looked around this congregation, it's full of nice people. A lot of Christians are just too nice. They're just too nice. They're too nice in two ways. They're too nice because they don't actually say the truth often. Okay, they see it, but they don't say it. Because they don't offend people. Offending people's never been a problem for you. And it shouldn't be a problem for you in the future. The second way they're too nice is actually a lot of them are full of fear. God says to them, go and talk to that person over there and just tell them that they're going to hell if they don't get their life sorted out, and they think, I'll have another cup of tea. See, the weapons in your hand is going to be the sword of the Spirit, the Word of God. And God wants you to be a violent man in the kingdom. Jesus talked about the kingdom of God coming through violence. Different sort of violence to the violence in your past. But violence. And God is calling you to violence of a different sort. Storming the strongholds of Satan. Speaking God's words in the situation. Pulling down those strongholds. And taking ground for the King. Without fear. Without fear of anybody. Because inside you is He who is greater than all. The King of Kings. And the Lord of Lords.
Amen.
Having heard of your repentance and your faith, we now baptize you, Lee, in the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Father, God, I want to pray now for the release of that spirit in Lee in a way that he's never seen it before. Moving from watching the 22-inch to being in the surround sound cinema. I want that spirit, Father, to be released in him, your gifts released in him and through him. You're going to give him insight into people's situations. You're going to give him prophetic words into people that aren't Christians. You're going to give him the boldness and the power and the strength to see miracles happen in people's lives as your spirit works through him. In Jesus' name, amen. Our God is an awesome God. Let's stand together. Last section of this meeting. Our next baptismal service is in 2 weeks' time. We have two people being baptised then already. So if God is speaking to you this morning, when there's an opportunity for response, as there will be in a few moments, you take that opportunity. Don't be like Beatrice and put it off for nearly 10 years. Don't put it off for 10 minutes. Make today your day to respond to God. Thank you, Adam.
We do hope you've enjoyed and benefited from this presentation. To learn more about what the Bible teaches us and how to apply this to our everyday lives, check out our biblical teaching and other videos at gbcweb.tv. And before you go, an invitation especially for you. Why not visit us at Greenford Baptist Church on the corner of Beechwood Avenue and Ruislip Road in Greenford, West London, the United Kingdom. Our postcode is UB69UA. Our phone number is 020 8575 5034 and our TV website is gbcweb.tv. We look forward to seeing you soon.